Hello, so today we are going to speak about how the flute works, and Shivram here, he's going to explain to us how the flute works. So Shivram, can you please tell us about the flute?
Yeah, definitely. So it's very simple actually. So I'll explain this through an experiment called a straw experiment. This experiment name was given by me itself. Okay. So here we have two different straws.
Yeah.
Okay, so I'll blow the air. So please tell me the difference. What difference you can hear? This is one thing. So what difference did you find?
There's definitely a pitch difference.
Yeah.
So one of them sounds shrill and one is sort of flat, I think.
Yes. So which one sounded shrill and which one was flat?
Yeah, this was shrill.
Yes.
And that was flat.
Yes, exactly. This was shrill and this was flat, right?
Yeah.
So why this is happening? So let me explain through the diagram.
Okay.
So we had two straws, right? So one straw was of the shorter length. So this straw is of the shorter length. So whenever we blow the air through this particular end, so there is the standing waves are, because of alternative compression and rarefaction, the sound standing waves are produced. So let me draw the standing waves here. So this is one diagram, and the second diagram I'll draw here. This is of a bigger straw. So see here, so what's happening here is this particular tube was of smaller length, and this particular tube is of larger length. So here the sound, here the wavelength, we know that wavelength is directly proportional to the length of the length of the tube, you know. So that's why, so here
it's visible here. For a smaller tube, the wavelength of this wave is shorter, here it is much larger.
Yes, exactly. So that's why, so this is of here the wavelength is small here, and here the wavelength is large, right? So we know the relationship between the wavelength as well as the frequency, right? The wavelength is inversely proportional to frequency. Let's look at what is inversely proportional. So directly proportional means they go along the same direction. So if one increases, the other will increase, and if one decreases, the other will decrease.
Okay.
This is the meaning of directly proportional.
Okay.
So inversely proportional means it goes in the opposite direction. So the wavelength increases, the frequency decreases. Frequency decreases, the wavelength increases. So here the frequency is small, so which implies, so the wavelength is small, so which implies that the frequency is large. So this implies that frequency is small. So here what we get in the larger tube, we get the smaller frequency, which means that the pitch of the sound is small. That's why we got the lower level sound in this particular straw. Here the straw was of smaller size, that's why the frequency is large. That's why we form the sound pitch to be very high. So now let me produce everything in a now they have a straw. So now I'll ask you one question. Tell me the answer now, right? So I'll cut this straw in this way. Now what I will do is I'll cut the straw while blowing the air simultaneously. I'll cut the straw. What do you think that will happen?
So I think if you cut the straw, the length will reduce. So I'm thinking for a smaller length, the frequency is larger. So the frequency should increase. The pitch should increase.
Exactly. So let's see what exactly is happening. Okay. Could you see this? What was happening? So in a single straw, we were able to produce different varieties of sounds.
Yeah.
So This is the basic principle of our flute actually.
Okay.
So one more straw I have. See this, the difference. So the difference between the previous straws and this straw is, so previous straw didn't have any hole, but this straw, these straws, they are having two holes in between.
Okay.
So now let's see what will happen.
It's like a flute.
Yeah,
right?
It's like a flute.
Similar. So yeah. Flute also has holes in between.
Yes, flute also have holes in between.
Okay.
Let's see what will happen. I'll blow the air.
So you can produce different notes with a single straw.
Yes. Yeah. Why this happened? Because so when I close this hole, the straw length was considered to be of this much.
Okay.
So that's why one kind of sound was produced. So when I opened this hole, the straw length was considered to be of this particular.
It becomes smaller.
So that's why the higher frequency sound will be produced. Higher
and
pitch will be produced.
When both are closed, it's the whole length.
Yes, it's the whole straw.
Okay.
So that's why three different sounds are produced when we had two holes.
Okay.
Right.
Okay.
So this is exactly the basic principle of our flute.
Okay.
So what is happening in flute is, so this is a Carnatic flute. So this is the Hindustani flute. So here we are having six holes as well as one hole to blow air here.
Okay.
So this hole for now we'll ignore.
Okay. Okay.
So here we can produce actually seven different kinds of sounds.
Okay.
Right.
Okay.
So one more than that. So we have seen here. So two holes were there. We are able to produce three sounds.
Okay. Okay. Okay.
So we are able to produce seven sounds here.
Okay.
So when I close this particular hole, the straw length, the flute length will be considered of this particular thing. So that's why one kind of sound is produced. When I close one more hole, this the length will be increased.
So the length, when you close these two holes,
yes,
this will be the length, right?
Yes, that will be the length. So when I close these two holes, this will be the length. Yeah, correct.
Okay,
correct.
Okay, okay.
Right. So when I close this particular hole, this will be the length.
Okay.
So it works in the following.
And why is this like oddly spaced? Like it's not evenly spaced. Right?
Yes, because all sounds are not pleasant, right? We want pleasant sounds.
Ah.
So to have pleasant sounds, they have calculated in such a way that these holes has to be in these particular distances.
Okay.
So we will get a pleasant sound.
Okay.
Now this is like, so we know in linear algebra, there is something called a generating set. Okay. That particular set is enough to generate all the elements of the space, right?
Okay. So just a small set of elements are enough to whatever is necessary, you can generate from that small set.
Yes, yes.
Okay.
So same kind of thing. I'm not telling it's exactly the thing, but same kind of thing is happening here also. See, we are having the six different holes. Using these different kinds of sounds, we can produce all varieties of songs, whatever songs we have. Okay, so it's not exactly these sounds. There are some brothers and sisters of these sounds. Say, for example, so if I close these holes, so one more hole, there is one more hole. I'm closing this half. So by this one more small variation of sound is produced. Say I'll blow it and I'll show. This is one sound. The small sister of this sound is this one. I'll show the clear difference.
Okay.
So these are both sounds are considered to be of same category.
Okay.
But because of their small variation, ultimately, when music comes out, there will be very huge variation because of the small variations
here.
Yes. So,
what is the whole note? If you from here to here, if you go, how does it sound like?
Okay.
This is much more deeper.
Yes, much more deeper. And the previously what I showed is. Right. We can observe the difference.
It's like half going halfway there.
Yes. Exactly.
Yes.
So using these kind of sounds, we can produce whatever the songs we have. We can sing using these notes here.
Okay.
So this is actually the basic principle of our flute.
Okay. And I'm curious. This is a bamboo flute, right?
Yes.
Can you explain how it's like made?
Yeah. So basically, they'll take a bamboo. Then they'll keep it for some 2 to 3 years as it is. They call it a seasoning.
Okay.
Yeah. So after that, after 2 to 3 years, then they'll take and they'll make holes. So how they make holes is like they have a iron. They keep it in the fire so that it will be heated up to very high extent, and they'll keep here and they start burning these things. So the holes will be created properly. Okay, and after that they'll refine the things. Okay. So ultimately, after having polishing all these things, we'll get a flute of this particular kind.
And it's closed at one end.
Right? Yes, it is closed at one end.
Okay.
This particular end will be closed.
Okay. So it's like a one side closed pipe.
Yes, one side closed pipe.
Okay. Hope you enjoyed this video on flutes. Please like this video if you did like it and subscribe to our channel. Thank you.
Thank you.